Welcome. This is the first of two explanation videos for the Mr. Wonderful assignment. This explanation video will run through how to set up Mr. Wonderful in working model, as well as inputting and calculating data. The inputting and calculating data will be focused on in the second video, which will be utilizing Excel. So you will want to make sure you have downloaded a copy of Excel to your computer. That can be done for free through your email login link on the butlercc.edu homepage. If you have any problems, don't be afraid to reach out. You should have my cell phone or your instructor's cell phone located in your syllabus to get a hold of them during this time. Okay, so we are currently in working model. I'm going to go ahead and flip over so you guys can see. So you guys are currently on my screen too, and you are able to see working model, and we're gonna build out working model. For this assignment, we need to pull some data from your spec sheet. I'm gonna run off of very specific specs that I have in front of me. Follow your spec sheet to make sure you get full credit on this assignment. If you are utilizing my specs, you may not get full credit. This assignment has Mr. Wonderful stepping out of a building. So in order to create this building, I'm going to create a stick. I need to make sure this stick is 1 meter high. So I'm going down here to height and changing it to 1 meter. I'm gonna click on this again and I'm gonna change that width down to 0.025 meters. And I want this located on the zero. And I'm gonna put the Y, because that's the center point of the whole stick, at 0.5. So that will put the base of my stick down here at 0, 0. So if I go to the center base of my stick, you can see I'm down here at 0, 0 for my location. So my stick has been located. Now this is gonna be the side of the building Mr. Wonderful is going to jump out. Next, I need to create a Mr. Wonderful. I don't have to be that accurate with Mr. Wonderful. We know from what we read that he is approximately a 5-inch tall doll. I know that inches convert into centimeters, 2.54. So I'm gonna say that he is around 12.5 centimeters. So that makes him approximately helps if you click on radius. So I'm gonna make Mr. Wonderful around 12.5 centimeters, so 0.0125. That makes Mr. Wonderful yay big compared to how far he's falling. Now I'm also going to wanna set up, he's measured in inches, so I'm gonna come up here to my view, and I want to view my numbers and units. I'm going to just for right now flip over to English. Notice that my stick hasn't changed. Now I'm now able to click on Mr. Wonderful and set him to 2.5 inches in diameter. Given that he's 5 inches overall, this gives me 2.5 from top to middle, another 2.5 from middle to bottom. So now I can go back into my numbers and units and return into my SI units. And notice that I have the correct calculated radius of 0.0635. So I know that I need to add to his X position, the 1 meter that he was, the Y position, the 1 meter that he was plus that 0.0635. Which will set his feet exactly level with that opening of that stick. And I'm gonna move him out approximately a tenth. This is just to get him off that stick for this calculation. So I've created Mr. Wonderful, created my building. Now I need something to reference as far as a ground. I'm just going to lay in another block down here. I'm going to call this ground. Now I want Mr. Wonderful to be able to collide with the ground or that stick, since they are objects in his world. I'm going to make sure that that collision is turned on. And I can see that it's turned on when I hit run. It falls. If you don't anchor it, everything falls though. So let's go ahead and anchor the building and the ground. So Mr. Wonderful can now fall. Now we said Mr. Wonderful was going to step out and grab a set of springs. So we'll need to add in a spring. We're gonna come over here to spring located on the left side in your constraints. We're gonna attach one spring to the center of Mr. Wonderful. And we're gonna attach this spring to the background just above Mr. Wonderful's head. Now notice here that as I pull on this, I get what is called down below SPL. That is spring length. And I'm gonna want to know that number. So I'm gonna set my spring length to 0.20. Here's why I want to know all the numbers that I've been indicating. I need to go set some information from my data now. So I'm going to double click to get to properties. You can also right click properties. And I'm going to put in that I want a KX spring, that its starting length is 2 meters. And it's K, and I'm going to change its K, say it's 1.4. Now when I run this, that spring will naturally oscillate out to its given distance. Now note, in working model, we haven't added anything like air friction or anything. So we end up getting a propagation of errors, but this really never stops bouncing. So if I want to get it to a place where it's going to stop bouncing, I have to preset my spring to where I think it's going to stop at. If I go too long, it will bounce up. If I go too short, it'll bounce down. Finally, I'll want to set Mr. Wonderful's mass. So we said Mr. Wonderful was going to set up with a set of weights in his arms. So let's say he grabbed 100 kilograms of weights. And then I would put Mr. Wonderful where I think 100 kilogram of weight would make him fall at and hit. Kilogram of weight would make him fall at and hit run. If I have too much weight, notice it has just fallen and smacked the ground. That effectively breaks Mr. Wonderful's legs, is not what we want. If I have close to the right amount of weight, I should be able to set Mr. Wonderful just above the ground, and rather than seeing him fall, I should see him hover at that height. So in this example, I could set him to only holding 50 kilograms worth of weights. And he still falls. And so you can end up playing around with this until you find the right amount of weight that Mr. Wonderful would have to hold to where he can step out the door and in theory ride this spring down. Now note here that we are not using a dynamic spring. We do not want to be in a situation where his mass is so light as to allow for a bounce. We don't want this bounce. We want a pure static, because the K value assumes a static spring. So this is how you set up the assignment for the Mr. Wonderful spring assignment. You know your delta x, that is the amount the string stretches from Mr. Wonderful only as you add weight downwards. That is given in the assignment extras that are located just below the spec sheet. And this is how you set up Mr. Wonderful and test Mr. Wonderful virtually. Have a great day.